is more of a fan of a bits because of the huge amount of research, the huge amount of initiatives taken by BITS Pilani all these years, the great work which it is doing, the technological advances which it is doing in technical education is something because of which BITS Pilani has created such a great magnetism academically around the world. And that's exactly the idea behind BITS Design School also, which we are very clear that we do not want to diminish but take it to a new level. So if you ask me how these ideas were born, there's a very simple thing. Many students, many parents are also coming and asking us about UGC compliance, etc., etc. So there is this Institution of Eminence tag which was given by the government of India to the BITS Pilani. It's one of those rare things which has been granted to a private institution in India. It's just equivalent to the Ivy League. It's like the Ivy League concept in the United States of America. And that's exactly what in India they also wanted to establish. So there are some very rare institutions which have got this tag. And BITS Pilani was right there in that list because of the huge amount of the work in education. When I say work in education, you can go and search about it. The legacy is as such that I remember that when I told my father, that I'm going to join BITS Pilani, not as a student, but as, as a head of admissions here, my dad started telling me, "Oh my God, my colleagues were from BITS Pilani. Why? You do not even think twice before joining." So that is the legacy. That means my father had colleagues. It's a 60-year-old institution which has done so much that its work speaks. You would see that, BITS Pilani does not do advertisements, it does not do anything, but each year there are so many students who appear for the same. And that is the legacy which each of the institutions which have come after it have maintained. So we started with BITS School of Management. It was started during the Corona times when, people were not very willing to even test something, new. But then the BITS Pilani's name is as such that even in the first batch of BITSOM, we had students who were amongst the 90 percentilers in CAT. The second year was exceptional, where they had students who rejected some of the IIMs for BITSOM. That has been the legacy. Then came BITS Law. The BITS Law was also something which created its own niche because, again, the admission process is something which separated it from the rest, where everyone was accepting just one score and, just permitting the student to become a law student. We were the ones who changed the entire scenario by interviewing the student. And it was not an interview, it was an interaction between, again, the faculty and the student. And that gave rise to such a furor in the industry that today I am being told that many others are also considering the same because you need to meet the student before you permit them, right? Then came BITS Design, the classic, and one of the most exceptional schools under BITS, which is doing so much that the kind of interest that we are getting from all around the parents, the daily walk-ins inside the campus, and I can see that on a Sunday afternoon, on a long weekend, parents investing their time. That's exactly what speaks about BITS Pilani. And something which we have consistently discussed in each of our webinars is admission process, and how distinctively we consider that we select those students who, as per us and the faculties, are able to go ahead and create better citizens and better brand ambassadors of not just brand BITS, but also of this country, is something which is very important to us. For which, each of those things which are going to be discussed in this webinar is going to be very important. For which, I have two faculties with me who would sit and explain to you the entire process because we need clarity of thought, clarity of purpose, even in the minds of aspirants as well as the parents when they apply to us. We do not want a confused person. We do not want someone who has just applied to us because of peer pressure. Our purpose, our aim is very clear. And that's something which we want to be very clear with even the aspirants who are applying to us. Okay. So, first and foremost, what I'll do is I'll share some important dates of ours, the admission dates of ours with our audiences. You may want to take a screenshot of all of these dates. I'll come to the dates, but before that, I have some ground rules for you, which I want every participant to be very clear about. This you can take a screenshot and keep. I'll tell you the dates and every important things. And then we move on with the session, where two of our distinguished faculties, whom I'm going to introduce, are going to tell you about the portfolio and the purpose of this webinar. Post that, you're going to take question answers. So if you have questions, there is a chat room which you have to use, make use of that chat room, right? At the end of it, we have a Q&A session where I'm going to take those questions. If you have a direct questions to one of our faculties, please name them also so that I can directly name them also. And please use your name so that I can even announce your name. For example, Geeta from Mathura or Madurai, whichever city you are, that I can do, right? So your questions can be answered like that also. Okay, so that's the process which we are maintaining. The faculties will try to cover maximum number of your doubts because that's exactly how we have curated this session. But just in case, if you have a specific question also, you can send it to us through the Q&A or the chat. My team is at the back end of it. Some of those questions which receive, like some links or something which you want, shall be shared with you quickly, there and then, okay? But those academic questions which you have, which you want the faculties to answer, that will be taken up at the end of it, right? So let's move on to the application status and dates, which are the most important. 30th March 2024 is what we have decided as the last date to apply for the students, okay? 1st to 5th April 2024, it's WITSDAT, which is our own entrance examination. It's a take-at-home examination. It's where you will receive a link on 31st March 2024. And this is one of those examinations where the score will be declared at the end of it, right? We are using the same mechanics as WITS Pilani does. You give the examination, at the end of it, you get your score. But score is not what is going to get you into WITS test. Because we believe, like I said, that a score before a name is not what will get you into WITS test. Our faculties would also have an interaction round with you, which is further going to be explained in this session. 1st to 8th April 2024 is what you would be doing, uploading of your NID, UC, WITSDAT exam score and other documents. If you're appearing for WITSDAT, then start uploading the documents after you take the exam, which is between 1st and 5th April. What are we doing? Why are we taking multiple examinations? Because at WITS, we have a philosophy that one entrance may not, because few hours, like Virat Kohli also gets out on the very first ball, right? That does not make him a bad batsman. So there can be a bad date for you also. You're sitting there, the fan is not working, something is going wrong, you have a personal problem. It's okay. You give entrance examination. One day you have to perform, right? That's called as consistency, that you know you submit to us your best score. So bits that, again, I repeat, is not a compulsory examination. If you have an NID score, you have a UC score, it's okay. You can even upload the same. Whichever is your highest, you can upload the same to us. Okay. Now, 11th April is where we start shortlisting of candidates for portfolio submission and interview, depending upon the score which you have. Okay. So it will be 11th April. Please take screenshot of this and keep moving on. 30th March. Now, this is again, the same thing. Moving on. Yeah. Now, 12th April to 15th April 2024 is where you have to upload the portfolios. When we shortlist you, we also expect you to create a portfolio, which is a very important component, which will be discussed today. Please listen carefully that what are we expecting from you? What are our expectations? How do people do it? Right? You have to upload the same. And that is only for the shortlisted candidates whom we will send letters to. Then from 14th to 20th April will be online interviews. So we had decided for city visits and doing it, but then we also believe in equity. So I would with pride tell you that there are no management seats in WITS design. There are no reservation seats in WITS design. It is only on the basis of merits that we take students. So we want to maintain equity. To maintain equity, it is important that all the interviews should take place in the same manner. So we have gone for online interviews for all students. So you can sit at your home. The process will be explained to you that how these can be booked and when and where and which faculty, etc., etc., are going to interview you. It will be all online. So you can sit at home and give the interviews, but there are certain rules like you should only be the person in the screen. No help should be given to you. We will explain it to you via email. Second week of May is what we are going to declare the results. Now, if you ask me what is how and how the totaling will be done and how the results will be declared and how the selection process is being done, qualifying exam will have 30% weightage, portfolio will have 30% weightage, and interview, like I said, this is the most important thing for us, will be 40% of the interview. right? This is exactly how we are going to go ahead. And I don't use the word select, selection, blah, 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 but this is exactly how we are going to create a pool of those select students we plan to train in the very first batch, which will be called our pilot batch. And we are very positive about that batch because they are going to get the best of the world and they are going to be the example and the brand ambassadors of Bits Design. So we are very clear about whom do we want to select, who is getting into Bits Design. So this interview process is also not just about your skill, but also about your attitude, also about your zest for life. Like we say, we need students with butterflies in their stomach who want to excel in their life, because that's exactly how all our faculties are also, right? So yeah, so moving on further. Now, rather than wasting more time, I know you guys are all ears to hear. What does a portfolio mean? What is the interview? Who would be taking it? How it would be conducted? So I have two distinguished and legendary figures from the field of design education with me. I would start with Binita Desai. I'll just introduce both of them and then they'll take it over. So Binita Desai is an acclaimed academician with nearly 4 decades of experience in academics. Of the 39 years she spent, 17 years at the National Institute of Design Ahmedabad. I'm 100% sure you all know this distinguished institution, which has created global presence. She has spent around 17 years there, freelance for 6 years, and spent the next 22 years at Dhirubhai Ambani Institute of Information and Communication Technology. She began her education with BFA in Applied Arts at Maharaja Shivaji Rao University, Baroda, another one of the best universities in this country, and went on to do her post-graduations at NID Ahmedabad from the 1980 to 85. Her areas of interest were animation, illustrations, exhibition design, and color. She was awarded a short-term professional training program conducted in London by UNDP. She has taught courses in animation, basic graphic design, illustrations, and audiovisual. She has also taught courses in nature and form, space form, and structure to foundation students. She has an interest in theoretical aspects of design methodology. She has developed and contributed to design courses for several reputed design and universities in India. Not just this, I cannot just frame some words. She is a legend in herself, and she is someone who's known to some of the best students who are working in some of the best positions currently in this industry. You know, that is what a teacher is all about. You can speak and speak and speak about them, but what defines them are the students, and she has students all around the globe. Our second panelist is Mr. Jitin Arora, a recipient of the prestigious Fulbright Nehru Master's Fellowship. Possesses over 21 years of experience in design and practice education. Now, someone who has got this fellowship, believe me, is one of those great people around to be taught and to be interacted with, specifically with the course like design, because this is one of those fellowships which is very difficult to get, okay, the Fulbright scholarship. He has held important positions at respected institutions like NID Ahmedabad, MIT ID Pune, DSK Supin Infocom, Rubika International Campus Pune, and the DICE ecosystem Mumbai, which has now become Atlas Skill Tech University. With a bachelor's degree in architecture and a master's degree in museum studies, he has specialized training in content and concept development for exhibitions. His expertise extends to film and animation, where he has garnered acclaim for short films made under his mentorship. Jitendra now embraces entrepreneurship, extending support to his family enterprise in scenic Lonavala and Khandala region. As he oversees a variety of projects involving home remodeling, renovation, narrative designing, and education, Jitin continues to demonstrate his passion for creativity and innovation. This is something which you can call as an introduction, but you will learn more about them in this session, because both of them are great human beings and exceptional teachers, which makes them my favorite also. So over to both of you. Please take the session and enlighten the students about the topic.
Thank you, Deepu. Thank you. And welcome everyone to this webinar. Binita and I go a long way, actually. Sorry, I've just started to speak, but allow me a few minutes where I would like to introduce Binita once more and through a more personal anecdote. So Binita and I go a long way, but the only opportunity that we've got to actually sit face to face and speak was in 1999, 25 years back, when Binita was assigned as a mentor. I'm sorry. To my
okay, I think there might be a correction error here somewhere. Vinita, can you hear me? You can start speaking in that sense.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Hello, everybody. I'm sort of a bit baffled. There are 367 people at this session. I'm quite amazed. But welcome to everybody. You must be wondering as to why BITS is asking for a portfolio work. The reason is very simple, that we want to know whether you're going to enjoy doing design and whether you have the potential to do it. So we have multiple ways of actually working through that and trying to understand whether you're going to actually have fun doing design. So do you have the will, the strength, the perseverance, because it's hard work, and the desire to actually join design as a discipline? So how do we do this? We're trying desperately to find out as to who you are as people. And there are multiple ways we figured out through the qualifying exams, through portfolios, and through the interview process that we might be able to somewhat figure out as to whether you would enjoy doing design. So who is this
person? I'm so sorry, Benita, to interrupt you. Sorry, I got logged out all
Not
of a
at
sudden.
All. Not
but I'm
at
glad
all.
you continue.
No, that's okay. Please carry on.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, everyone. This was just sudden, not expected at all. And believe me, we've done several dry runs and none of this happened, but I guess no one can control this. So sorry, I was just going on with your introduction, actually, and sharing the anecdote. So yeah, I was saying that, is it okay if I carry on?
Yes, please.
So I was saying that we were all very nervous. And when we first met Benita, of course, the sessions were very eye-opening. But at the same time, what we found very, very endearing was a calming energy that she brought with her.
Oh.
Okay, I think we can
At the
carry
same time,
forward.
making
Yeah,
sure
yeah.
that we don't. So that's the kind of impact that teachers lose and answering anxieties.
We'd lost your audio.
Oh, is it?
Yes.
I'm so sorry. It's just misbehaving right now, the internet. So with that confidence that Benita is just the right person for this interaction, I just throw those questions, and I'm sure Benita, you'd already started to speak about it. But
yes.
What is a portfolio, and why is it required at the start of a student's career in design? And then, of course, about the interview and how are the interactions with design faculty different from, say, any other interviews? Please carry on. I'll mute myself.
Okay, thanks. So like I was saying, so BITS is trying to figure out as to who you are as personalities. And so this entire process of doing a qualifying test, submitting a portfolio, and the interview process, which are all linked to each other. So you'll find that during the interview process, you will also be asked questions from your qualifying exam and from the portfolio for continuity. So the narrative has to be continuous and it has to belong to you, right? So we want to know whether you're going to enjoy doing design, and therefore looking at whether you have the will, the strength, the desire, the perseverance to actually pursue design. And the portfolio, the qualifying exam, and the interview process will give us a fair idea of who you are and whether you would enjoy doing design and have the potential to become a designer and enjoy a career in design. So the reason why I connected all of these three steps in the admission process is because you would eventually in the interview process also have to be able to answer questions regarding the qualifying exams and your performance therein and the answers you've given there and the work that you have submitted in the portfolios, whether it's through images, through words, or through voice, right? So in the portfolio, what we're looking at is what are your passions? So everything you've learned is important. Don't leave anything behind, because in design, you never know what comes in handy and at what point in life. So if you say, oh my God, I'm going into design, I think I can forget about biology. No, you're mistaken, because biology, what it teaches us, has immense value in design. So what are your passions? And are you going to be able to express those passions either through your through any of the three steps, which is the admission test, through the portfolio, or through the interview? So if you have anything which is even incomplete and you can connect it through a set of words without stressing too much, submit it, because it's a great piece of work or a great idea, right? So don't get nervous about, oh my God, I don't have a portfolio and therefore what am I going to do? You've learned a lot of things in all these years. And there are things that you're obsessed about, you have a passion for, put it all together and submit the work. So is there a sense of excitement you have? Depict it through the work that you have. Is there a sense of curiosity and passion and sense of observation? Put it together in whatever form. If it's through a series of photographs, or it's just through drawings or doodles, and connect it with a certain number of words so that it tells us a bit of a story. Because there might be two drawings that you've done, and if you submit them independently, I don't know what you're talking about. But if you just write a couple of lines in between and connect the two images, then I know what it's all about. So don't get worried or get stressed about the fact that you do not have a portfolio. There are a lot of students who have actually probably had an intention of doing design and therefore have gone to coaching centers, right? But putting the story together is your job. You might have learned bits of things in the coaching center, but how do you see it as a story? What are you thinking about? And how are you thinking about the things that you're actually doing? Are we giving it enough thought or not? So your writing is actually going to connect these things. Don't spend sleepless nights trying to do drawings in between to make connections, etc. That's not the idea. The idea is to know how you think, who you are as a person, and the way you are today, right? So bring everything together and try and let us see who you are. We also want to see how you connect to the world around you, to your family, to your grandparents, to the animal world around you, through your the environment around you. Do you travel? What do you enjoy about traveling? These are all the narratives that we are actually looking for that you have experienced personally. And why I say personally is because in the interview, you might be asked about the journey and to detail out the journey that you spoke about in the portfolio. And you don't want to be found wanting, where you've not really experienced the journey, it's been somebody else's, etc. So you don't want to do that. You want to put in only what you have done, right? So because BITS Design School is trying to understand who you are as a person, right? So there is the possibility of actually submitting all this work through the portfolio in two formats. One is putting a PDF together of 25 MB, and that is compulsory for all students, right? You can put in an additional, but it's optional, 25 MB file of any video work you've done or audio work you've done. And by audio, it could be anything. building a music track for a small film you've done, or for somebody else you've done. You sing, or you enjoy animal bird sounds, some recordings that you've done, conversations which were interesting, which you have recorded, you want to put up, and can share with the group that is going to be evaluating with the portfolio and with the interview committee. So the choice is yours. And the only thing you have to remember is that we trying to understand who you are as people, and each one individually, and no person is identical. So don't look at somebody else's portfolio and think that, oh, that's the way I've got to do it. There is no rubber stamping here. Know who you are. So Jitendra, does that...
Yeah, actually it does. But I guess we have a couple of slides here, which would also help you kind of connect the dots in the form of a for the students. So could we have those slides on, Kumaran, the next slide? Yes, so I think Vinita was talking about telling us a story of who you are and what your passions and obsessions and likes and dislikes are. But we expect, since it's your story, we expect it to have the main character energy, right? You are not going to be doubtful about it. It's your story, so you can tell it with as much certainty as you can. And we welcome that. Now, but what does this story, what could this story entail? And Benita has spoken about it, but let's just go over it once more. What all could this story entail? So Benita has said that there have to be images and words through which you will express this story. Words are also very important because this portfolio has to be self-explanatory. Because it would be reviewed in isolation, which means that there be a person watching your work on screen, but they will have no clue who you are. And therefore, it's very important for you to leave certain clues in verbal manner for us to understand and connect the dots that you kind of have in your story. But words by words, we don't only mean explanation. We also mean artistic creative work. So creative writing, for example, any poems that you've written, any interesting work that you've done in writing, that is also welcome. Of course, designers are supposedly visual people. So images work a lot in your favor, but words are important too. Am I right, Vinita?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Would you like to elaborate? I know it'd be a slight repetition, but just so that everyone gets it, would you like to elaborate on the other points? Like, what made you choose design? Isn't that a very intense question to answer?
Yes, it is. So I think one is looking at how do we judge whether we can do design or not? What are the things we enjoy doing? What is the latitude of our capability or our interests? Do I like working with my hands? Do I enjoy thinking? Do I like to sing? Is it multisensorial? Because design solutions and things are always multisensorial. So do I like making inventive dishes for the family in the home? And do I experiment? And do I combine things which people don't usually combine together and try and test it out? So what are the signals that you've had sort of made you consider design as a possible profession?
Understood. Very well explained. I think we all like to tinker with things around, and especially food. I mean, I've done so much of experimentation, and a lot of time it is detested by my family, but I enjoy it all the same because it's my creation. But to use that as a signal to know that I have a creative mind, I think that's insightful. That's very, very useful to know. Anything that's beyond the regular way of doing things could be regarded as creativity. Excellent. But here
and
I
also
think...
Sorry, can I just interject here one moment? Can I say something? Well, I was also looking at the idea of, we use the word casually, local and global, but I think there is the vernacular and the universal. And I think there are interesting solutions in the vernacular which are worthy of observation. And I think, how do you look at all of this which is around your world? Just a simple shopkeeper who sort of has a little gizmo which can take off the husk from a coconut, you know? That's a really inventive, very simple mechanical tool. But does my observation go to it and say, oh my God, that's really creative? So what all do I look at and what do I observe? And do I have the mind which actually wanders in terms of asking myself, you know, these kind of various questions?
Absolutely, absolutely. So it's not just what one does, but also what one sees or chooses to see and prioritize in their own story. That's wonderful. But how would I know what I'm excited to learn about? I mean, my school would have taught me all the subjects, and being a good student, I would have tried to put in equal effort in learning everything. How do I know what am I excited to learn?
Well, there are some passions that I have. And I, in fact, sometimes passions also turn into obsessions. And I think there is something that drives everybody to be passionate and obsessive about something, you know. So I think in design, you need perseverance and you need to go at it with a passion which will allow you to arrive at an end. And if you have that, then that's a great quality, that you're passionate and you're obsessive about something. It's great.
And what if I said I was passionate about sports more than studying or tinkering with material? How would that quality be considered a good quality for becoming a designer or for being trained as a designer in an institute like BITS Design?
Well, I think sports is about the human body, and you're looking at, there's a, you know, sense of, it works in a composite way. All the organs, etc., are all working in a composite way. And I think we're looking at the universe also working in a composite way. So how do we extrapolate things that we have in a unit, like a brick can make a building, so the body can give us a sign of how other bodies are working. So there is a sense of sympathy, empathy, understanding of if I can see something, that something can be, that somebody can be seen by me. I mean, they can also see me. So there's a reciprocity in being able to understand your own bodies. And I think sports does this in a terrific sort of a way, where it also almost makes you sort of work, look inward in terms of what the tenacity of the human body is. And it also almost gets to a philosophical and spiritual level at some level. And there is a long distance runner has an extremely meditative quality about him. And I think the body teaches the person that sense of moving outside the physical, but it's stemming from the physical.
Excellent, excellent. Thank you so much. There are some details here on the screen which the students may want to know, sort of take a screenshot of. So not only have you, we have suggesting you to throw in a story at us, but also in how many pictures or how many words you could throw in. So there are certain specific points here. So in case your questions on the chat box are about how many pictures I could include, well, there are answers. If you need some more specific information, then we've said, okay, two drawings that you've done manually and at least one computer generated image. We'd really like to see how well are you able to observe things using your drawing skills. And if you are at all comfortable using digital, any digital software, then we'd like to see that. So it doesn't necessarily mean you've got to draw it out, but if you've tinkered with anything digitally and created something exciting, please do share. Don't hesitate. And of course, like we said, your story has to be self-explanatory. So sometimes you need words to connect different seemingly disconnected works of yours. Do tell us that story as well with words. You could write those words right at the beginning, giving us an introduction of who you are and why you're presenting certain, why you've chosen some work to show us, or you could give it at the end to sum up your portfolio, or you could even connect dots in between by writing captions or subtitles with your pictures. And if you have any verbal work, written work or auditory work that you've done, that is welcome too. All right. Could we move on to the next slide, Kumaran? Yes. So this is just a recap of what Binita had already stressed upon. The file sizes, I think some of the questions that we have already started getting is how much should I really submit and how should I compile it digitally? So we are very specifically telling you that this is a PDF file, which is less than or equal to 25 MB. That's compulsory for everyone. So no matter what the quality of work, please don't hesitate to share, because you might not realize it, but we may see something extremely important in there, and that could become a point of conversation in the interview. And optionally, if you have any video work, because I know a lot of people are on Instagram and they keep creating reels, and believe me, I take reels very, very seriously. I like to create as well, but they're not as great as young people's work. So I respect that. So if you have any audio or video work that you've done, which could be funny, which could be engaging, which could be intriguing, we welcome that as well in addition to the PDF file that you submit. Of course, it's optional. No stress. Don't take stress. It's okay. If you don't have that, you're not disqualified. Okay. Moving on. Yes. So the interview process. So people have, are you able to hear me?
Okay. Yes.
So about the interview process, we've covered some points about portfolio, what should be in the portfolio and the story, but what really happens when a student comes into the interview room online in this case and faces a faculty like you and me. And of course, I think every interviewee, no matter what, even I am today nervous about my interview, right? If I'm going to face someone who's judging me, I'd always be very nervous, and I'm not sure how to really cast a first good impression. So any tips on that, Binita, or any guidance on that, please?
Well, I think the first thing is to sort of know that the point of the interview is to really understand every individual better. And therefore, however you communicate, in whichever language you communicate, I think the communication part is the most important. Don't leave out anything which will let us know you better or understand you better, right? So, and like I said, that the questions will also come from qualifying tests, from the portfolio, and the narrative will continue all the way to the interview process. So you have to make it your own story, right? And so there can be an engaging conversation, because there are some things that are better spoken out in words and can be done during the interview process. Some things which did not get conveyed through images and text can actually get conveyed in the interview process. So they would also want to know other things like, how do you acquire the knowledge that you've acquired up until now? What are the methods you use? Do you travel? Do you ride a bicycle? Where do you go? Do you meet friends? What kind of conversations do you have? Do you read? And if you read, what do you read? If you listen to music, which groups do you listen to and why? Who the drummer is of that group, if there is a drummer? Yeah, so what is the level of information that you actually store, or do we just know the names of groups and not know who's actually playing the saxophone or the flute or the sitar or whatever? So what is the level of curiosity that you have, and how do you build the knowledge base that you already have?
No, please keep going.
Yeah. So if you have interesting things that you have read, then who are the authors you read? Or do you read disparate? So do you like thrillers as a genre? So then you read different authors. Yeah, so what is it about thrillers that you enjoy? So the questions could actually trail off from who you present yourself to be. And those will become the prompts for the interviewer also to ask you further questions. So you can either make it interesting, the interview process, by actually bringing to the table little anecdotes or stories or things that you want to share with a group of people. It's not really a daunting interview panel in that sense, as much as a group of people who are trying to understand you better.
Thank you so much. I think it lifts off the pressure a bit. But we'd also go on to the next slide and maybe request you to elaborate on a few more points. So here we've said that we'd like to, you've already talked about knowledge and curiosity, but then there is some more words here that people may want to unpack. Would you please help us do that?
Yeah, so knowledge is something that you know how it works, that it you actually begin to draw connections. You sort of digress from the main line of reading. You've read something interesting and you go and look up that interesting little aspect. So you're building a bigger and bigger base of reading, even that one book that you're reading. Yeah, so it keeps expanding and you get to know more and more because you're going out to search for something. So an awareness is really, what is the kind of world you have lived in so far? And have you been conscious of how you get to school, say, for instance? Yeah. What is the fuel that the bus uses every day? Yeah. What is the cost of fuel? Do I know my, these are very pragmatic things I'm talking about. But once you look at, once you understand how knowledge is acquired, then you're also beginning to understand that, oh, if I've read something about forests, then I'm actually looking at ecology as a system and I'm acting on it. Yeah. So do I engage with my environment? Am I part of an ecology group or an environmental group in my society or in my school? What are the levels of curiosity you have that do you actually explore possibilities? Yeah, that do you go to new and different places? I know we all go to new and different places for food. Do we do this for, you know, other things as well? So, what is the desperation with which we actually seek all these things? Is there, do we do it on one day and, you know, say, oh, well, I don't think I can do it another day? Or do we keep it? Is it consistent? Yeah. So consistency is also building a wider sense of awareness. Your curiosity sort of expands and your awareness increases and therefore your knowledge base increases. So how do we actually systematically chase certain things that we are passionate about, obsessed about, right? And with this, we are asking questions. So we're looking for explanations and we become thoughtful about it, saying, why is this like this? Or how would it be if it was different? If I put in something in between two pieces, then how would it alter? Will the machine start going in reverse? Will it, you know, or would I be able to put something so that my bicycle works better? Or how do I turn this information, knowledge, into something that I can act upon and quite inventively and, creatively. So we've all tinkered and made toys while we were young and it's actually grown. I'm sure everybody in this group has probably started using a mobile phone at age 2 at whatever level. So that's technology for you. You can't see the workings of it, but in the mechanical world, you can actually see how things are moving. So in school, you've probably built sort of, you know, objects and things like that, which have actually created a great sense of excitement. Anything beginning to work, putting two things together and it beginning to move, creates a great sense of excitement. So I'm sure you've been in those spaces. So bring that all into way you want us to see you as a person. Yeah. And communication skills is don't let it pass. If you've not been able to explain it with in the same language in a particular way, just say, no, let me rephrase it and try again. If you wanted to combine two languages to communicate it better, because something said in Hindi or in Tamil or in Marathi convey a particular sensation or a nuance much better than the English language can. So do you want to bring that in order to be able to convey what you want to say more emphatically and more clearly? Yeah. And when we're looking at social skills aspiration, we're really looking at how you negotiate your social space. Yeah. How approachable you are, or how you approach people. Yeah. Is there a joy? Do you welcome people with sort of fun and laughter and excitement? And how do you engage with them? Are you willing to share and help? And be friends with multiple people, and with elders, what is the way you behave? Are you awkward? Are you shy? It doesn't matter if you're shy. You can there'll always be somebody who will help you get out of being shy. But never fear from engaging with people, right? And aspirations, of course, I'm sure there are aspirations of all kinds. We all want to change the world, but that's a far cry. I mean, but we can try to change certain things around us, within ourselves, immediately within our environments. So aspirations can be of all kinds. They can be of a physical nature, of a social nature, psychological nature, emotional nature. They can be all kinds. So what is the aspiration you have? And I think an exciting proposition to be a student in this batch, because you'll be the founding batch. You're going to set the tone and tenor for the batches to come. So what is the level of excitement, social skills, norms, culture that you will set in place, which your juniors can then follow? So have fun and make it worth your time.
Thank you, Victor. Thank you so much. But while we were talking, I also had the opportunity to look at the questions, the some 80-odd questions that we've got on the chat box on the Q&A board. And I'd like to tackle some of those, because some of them are very direct, talking about does it have to be a PDF file, or can I upload a Canva file? Can I upload links to my, say, Google Drive, where you can browse through the entire work that I've done? I think you'll have to stick to this rule that we have made. Try and convert everything or compile everything into a neat PDF. Make sure that it's not more than 25 MBs of size and show it to us. We don't want to go through the entire body of work that you've done, but we want to see works that help you tell the story in a concise but clear manner. So say something about your life, which was an important incident about your life, where you'd either talked about it through a written piece, or you've taken pictures, or you're just the memory of it, you've enjoyed drawing about, or in any way that has cast an impression and you've been expressing about it in any of the mediums, just include that in your portfolio and make sure that it tells something about your personality. So, Canva files, Google Drive links, we're not accepting at this moment. Do not cross-link anything. Try and put everything as a PDF. And let it be under 25 MBs. Also, you said that some of them are asking about drawing skills. I don't have great drawing skills, but I may have good digital skills, and vice versa. I have only good drawing skills and I haven't used any digital software. Don't worry. All of this that we are telling you is a suggestion for you to understand what possibly you could include. Don't start getting nervous about it. If you have good drawing skills, please include them. Please express yourself through drawings. If you have good photography skills, please express yourself through photography skills. If you have a mix of everything, great. If you have only good digital skills, please, please bring that forward. So please, when you, so the meaning of main character energy is that whatever is important about you, whatever is significant about you, what is it that you enjoy sharing, you must be able to share through any medium. Let the medium not be an obstruction to you telling your story. But at the same time, we encourage that you use the mediums of images, any kind of text, any kind of words, spoken or written, recordings, Instagram reels, TikTok videos, whatever you've created, short skits you've done, all of that is welcome as long as it helps us understand who you are and what you are bringing to the table as the founding batch of BITS Design. So I guess a lot of these questions that were repeated in the list of 80 questions that I read, I hope those are answered. Right. And of course, there'd be many more, and our entire admissions team is paying attention to your questions. And if you don't get them live here, please do not worry. Someone will get back to you and they will answer that question. Right. If you're uploading YouTube videos, you have to download them. And you have to make sure that those videos are in the optional video category and do not take more than 25 MB. So you'll have to compress them, find a way to compress them. There are a lot of free websites that tell you how to compress your videos. Use them and compress it. If we wish to see a higher quality at the time of interview, we'll ask you to show the original video and play it for us. It's online interview, so you can obviously go online and show it to us. But do not worry at this stage. Just stick to what we have given you and present the best that you can. Right now, about a lot of questions about how many applicants, how many seats, all of that, the admissions team will take care of those specifics. We're not here to answer those, but anything that's relevant to portfolio and interviews, where we would be able to clarify. One of the questions was, what type of questions will be asked during online interview? Anything that helps us to know you better. Vinita has emphasized enough on the fact that portfolio tells your story and interview reinforces that story. So we are not going to be, it's not a viva. We're not testing your knowledge essentially only. We want to know you. And the question could be, hey, tell us about yourself. Hey, could you elaborate? This is very interesting. Something interesting we saw in your portfolio. Could you tell us why did you make it or what happened while this was going on? So it could be just some sort of a conversation around the work that you have done, which would help us know you a little better. So I guess we've answered.
Jitendra, can I just interject
yes.
here?
Yes, please, please.
Yeah, just one more thing that you've got to constantly remember is that you're coming to learn design. We just want to know who you are today, right? So that's the only thing. So don't get worried and stressed. We just want to know who you are today. Would that be fair to say?
Yes, yes, yes. In fact, one of the questions, Kumaran, you've switched off the slides at the point when I was going to ask you to move on to the next slide. There was one very interesting question where an applicant had asked, could you give us suggestions on what possibly I could include in the mm-hmm. portfolio? And I think some of our forthcoming slides talk about that. There are six ideas that we have for students. And we'd like to share that. Kumaran, could you please switch on the slideshow once again, please? Thank you. So in response to the questions where people are asking about, hey, what could I include? Vinita, could you please elaborate on some of the ideas that we have? These are suggestions again, okay? This is not mandatory. If you don't have it,
yeah, so there could be some models that you have made as part of your curriculum in school. They could be science models. It could have been in a craft class. It could have been in a workshop that was conducted in the summer. And you enjoyed working with your hands. So right from the idea of what you made to how you made it becomes a very interesting way of actually beginning to understand you. So if you want to show some model you have made, you can actually show a general picture. You could take a detail of it because you want us to see a detail of some connections you've made or joineries you've made or the texture on it or anything at all. So models are one thing that, and prototypes are one thing that you can do. It can include digital models as well. So there's no stopping you from sharing digital models that you've made. So if you've made models for animation or for in AutoCAD or this or that, anything at all can are welcome. But it must be within the formats that have been specified. So I'm sure a lot of schools have got workshops where you can build robots. So if you have participated in anything like that where you've used tools and you've built something, put something together which moves, or even if it doesn't move, it could be a sculpture, it could be anything where material has actually come together and there have been ways in which you have connected it, either with tools or without tools. So it could include visual narratives where you're looking at comic strips, maps, artworks, paintings, photographs. Some people even might, on a family trip, find it interesting to make maps of where they're all going to go or where they went, and the school might have asked you to write about a trip you've made, and you've made maps. They're very interesting and are an interesting way to talk about a journey. Comic strips, for instance, just a very short idea of something that actually took place in reality, or you just thought up and you wanted to turn it into a set of three or four pictures and it tells a story. That's wonderful. Paintings and photographs. Everybody has a camera and they're constantly taking photographs. So are there any interesting ones that you think explain or convey who you are extremely well? So if you want, you can write a couple of words to explain those images. That would be great. Any apps that you have made or websites or prototypes, it could have been part of a health science project or science project or anything at all, you can submit that as well. But stills of it actually, and you can show the working of it. If it's up and running, you can actually show that during the interview process, right? Next. Any video, animation, music, and poetry, or if you sing and you play an instrument, put in a recording of it, a small clip of it, and allow us to hear how you play the flute or the guitar or the drums or any instrument that you enjoy, or you do a cappella, you just sing and perform with your own voice and body. That's great. Any animation that you have done, everyone's enjoyed doing, lotties and little moving GIFs for websites. I'm sure some of you have done that. Any videos that you have shot, which are interesting, it could have been on trips that you have made through school or through the family, or even just going back and forth in school. I don't know, maybe there is something like that. So any creative collaboration you've done with people, for instance, your blogs you've set up or, projects you've done or journeys you've taken or whatever, but you must be very clear paintings you've done, wall paintings or murals or, any experimentation with food or images you've done for, the city some drive, you know, cleanliness drive or garbage drive or whatever it may be. And the only thing you have to remember is to clearly state what specific part you played in it. Yeah, it might have been a group project, but you might want to state exactly what you did in it. Next. Okay, so this is just reiterating that the PDF file of 25 MB is compulsory for all. And the audio video file with an additional 25 MB is optional.
Cool. There was...
Have we reached the question answer round?
Yes.
Okay. There are a lot of questions. a lot of questions. 200 questions have already been answered by the team. Kudos to them. They have been working really hard. Some of them are still open. Most of them are related to placements and other things, which we had taken a separate webinar for the same. So I will not be discussing the same here. You can go to our YouTube channel and there is that video where we have talked about placements. See, average placements, blah, blah, blah. If I have a general answer, which I give it for every discipline, that if an institution can guarantee a student placement even before mentoring him or you know, even before allowing him to attend few classes, I myself was a student, so I can tell you that even the people who are asking these questions know the same answer, that it would be a lie to not know a student and then just promise on the face of it that placement guarantee. It actually depends upon the student, that does he have those things to get placed. In the admissions process, one of our criteria is also to check whether the student suits the course or not. Because in India, you know, even an opinion by a neighbor is considered as an advice and career decisions are taken, right? So that should not be a case here. And that is why when we meet a student, we do check for those things, but then it's a four-year journey between us and the student. So anything can happen in those 4 years. But what we can guarantee you is, by the grace of God, we are a BITS Pilani institution. You know, that's something which I always say. I say that with a lot of responsibility because I can 100% vouch for it, that out of all those attendees which we have here, around 350 people, some of them are 100% BITS Pilani alumni. And they know what I'm speaking about, the kind of ownership they have towards their alma mater. Because of which, you won't believe it, the day BITS design was conceived, I cannot name some of them, but some of the major companies in this country who are the founders of that company and who own those startups which are doing wonderfully well in this country, reached out to us on the 24th of February when we were inaugurating a new campus, calling out that they want to contribute, they want to play students, they want to be a part of this great revolution, because for them, BITS Pilani is graduating to new levels, right? It is now not just technical education, it is into management, it is into in law, it is into design, and design is something which really, you know, and which is something which is driving them. And you won't believe it, their contribution to this institution is also something where they were the ones who came out with the specialization and said, see, these are the things which come, that there are AI and so many other developments which are happening. They were the ones who said, okay, this is exactly how the design industry is going to go into. So rather than making an average package, crore, lakh thing, or creating a mirage in front of you, I can tell you, we are creating a kind of an academic aura with faculty, students, and facilities. You are all welcome to our new campus at Kamba in Kalyan, where you can come and see the great work which we are doing. The manner in which it is getting created. Plus, you can also come to our interim campus at Powai, which is in Hiranandani Knowledge Park, and come and visit and check the great contribution to design education which is being made by BITS Pilani in form of this institution. And how I also go back to the first anecdote which I used, I said that students are actually products. You know, who are our customers at BITS? It's the industry. It is the people who would come for placements are our customers here, because we have created products who themselves either would become entrepreneurs or else they would go and contribute to our customers who are these placement people who would come and place. And their expectations from us is so high that they want to come and fetch students from us with a confidence that they are so confident that if BITS is involved, something magic is going to happen and the products or the students are going to do exceptionally well. This has been our experience with our School of Management and also of Law. Law students are just 6 months old. They have gone for their internship, and you should check the Instagram page, the great work that they're doing, the kind of awards that they're getting. And that's the same philosophy which is behind BITS Design also. And I often say this, there are a lot of people who apply to me and say that, you know, we want to become faculties at BITS. I tell them, I can't help you. All I can do is I can make sure that your resume reaches out to our HR. But then you have to go through a process. To become a BITS Design faculty is also a big thing. You know, a BITS Pilani faculty has to go through a lineage of checks and balances, because that's their legacy. You know, that's exactly what they have. And that's what they believe in, that a student and a faculty is something which is the most important thing. And given all these things which we are doing, placement should not be an issue to us. You know, given the group's backing, it belongs to the Aditya Birla group, and everything else apart, even we need not move on to that backing. The industry itself is expecting so much from us that 100%, I can assure you that placement would not be a problem for a student who makes good use of the facilities, faculties, and everything else which we are going to provide in that conducive environment. So I hope that answers the question, right? And we have our own prestige at stake, so we are not going to, you know, just throw away and say, okay, this badge, let it go. And this is our pilot batch. Like I said, we are very positive about our pilot batch. So we are not going to have students who do not get any kind of placements. We'll push. There is a separate office which has been set up just to look into the to the placements and even training and you know, internship for the student. Right? So yeah, there is a question, Vinita, which the students have been asking us, and that relates to the topic here. They are asking us, what do you mean by a computer generated image? You're on mute, I guess.
A computer generated image could be one that is sort of done with AI, or it could be something which is drawn on a digital platform. It could be something where you've given prompts and the computer has generated a visual version of that textual prompt. Does that cover all of it, Jitendra?
Yes, I mean,
otherwise, just a second. The prompts that your mind has given to you, and that has enabled you to create something on any digital platform, right? So there's a variety of digital platforms that we have, online as well as software that you download and work with. So if you have access to some of those and you've worked with it, tinkered with it, do please include your digital one. The output would be in the JPEG or PNG form that would be uploaded into the PDF, of course.
Okay, so there's just one response to this, that the distinction being that there are a lot of things that you can go back in digital technology to a previous stage, or you can save multiple stages. But when you do something with your hand, you have to be extremely thoughtful. If you're doing a watercolor, you have to be careful. If it's a mistake, you have to start all over again with a fresh sheet of paper. So the ability involved in both is quite different and allows us to understand how you work much better.
Good. There is a question which I would want both the panelists here to answer as teachers, because this is a career advice where Yogendra Rana is asking me, a BTech candidate who has no background and wanted to pursue B design, please guide as to where she should start.
Yeah, do you want me to take this?
Yeah,
yes, Benita, please go ahead. Please go ahead, Benita.
Yeah, where should she start? Well, I think for one thing, not to throw away the BTech knowledge, to retain the BTech knowledge, and to build on the BTech knowledge with design, and start at the very beginning as far as design is concerned.
I think that sums up. That's the perfect answer. I have nothing to add to that.
Okay. Shelly Rathore is asking us, is our portfolio supposed to consist of topics that are given to us in case we are shortlisted, or previous work that we have done? Should I repeat the question?
Of course, your previous work. Of course, your previous work.
So there is a question by a student. I'll answer that. Will there be a waiting list? Obviously, because we are not looking for a crowd in the campus. We're just looking for 120 select students, which is a fixed seat by us. We are not going to increase it. So the selection process will start, and obviously there will be a rank list, and there will be a waiting list also, and which will be communicated to you. There is a question by Manvi Kaushal. She is asking, can I post an edit I made on two actors?
Absolutely. Why hesitate? I mean, if that's something important to you, and you've, sure, memetic work is the in thing, and it has a certain humor and wit to it. We'd like to see that. Yes.
Wow. Great. Another question by an anonymous attendee is, does the optional file can include dance?
Yes. Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Okay. Akshita Rajni is asking us, what includes under the compulsory computer generated work?
We've clarified that it's not compulsory anymore. It was suggestive. Yeah, it was suggested to you that you include that in case you're running short of ideas. But if you don't have it, it's okay. So we were just basically talking about images that you've generated using a digital platform, which could be an online digital platform like Canva, or it could also be any other software that you have access to and you've tinkered with it, but you've created something meaningful. So a lot of time people create drawings, people create paintings, people create abstract expressions. We'd like to see it. I cannot specify more than that because everyone's different and they have different skills and access. But if you've tinkered with it and there's something exciting you've done, please show us. Don't hesitate. It's your story.
True. Nandita Vishwanathan is asking us, can the computer generated image be digital art or Procreate?
Yes. So I didn't want to take names actually, but yes, Procreate is one of the more commonly available, more used application today on iPads. Sure, if you've done something, please take the output in a format that it could be a part of the PDF and show to us. Why not?
And just can we add over here, if you've used ChatGPT to do any textual work, please just indicate it. Indicate that this has been done using providing prompts to ChatGPT and then been written.
If you're using AI, I would be interested in knowing the prompt you've used more than the output.
Exactly.
For me, the prompt writing is actually more of design than what ChatGPT does and gives you.
Dakshita Gupta is asking us, is a computer generated image mandatory or multiple handmade work items are also allowed?
We've clarified that. Yes, yeah. It's nothing is mandatory. It was suggested just to give an idea of what all you could include.
Yeah. And how many audio video pieces are needed is one of those questions.
Anything that fills up your 25 MB limitation. So there could be four different files. It could be one big file. That's totally up to you. But if it's relevant to the conversation of your story, don't just give us random files. Give us something relevant, but do not use more than 25 MBs of space.
Okay. Now, there's a very interesting question here where the student is asking, during the online interview, will our appearance matter or is it just our talent?
Let us put that question back. How do we look? How do you judge us today on our appearance? And does that matter? Maybe to an extent, I am not sure, but I think ultimately it's the knowledge that you gain out of the session that matters. Similarly, the experience that we draw out from having conversed with you would matter a lot to us. Be decently dressed, if I could add to that, just so that we can have an easy conversation, and the conversation just doesn't go around your appearance. So, and even if it does, what's the harm? Even if it's about your appearance, what's the harm? Be as quirky as you are.
Yeah. So Siddhay Dabke is asking a question which I'll answer. Is the exam going to be difficult as compared to other design exams? We will not call it as a difficult examination because we are not here to torture the students, or we are not here, that test is not to eliminate students. Rather, we are just here to test your aptitude for design courses. You know, so we are not even looking at the difficulty level as such, but yes, it won't be a cakewalk. It won't be like anyone can come and just score, you know, because we, as I said, it's basically a journey of 4 years without any exit option for you. And it's a question about your life, your parents' hard-earned money. So we have to be very, very clear that which student are we permitting, right? So our test, I cannot say that it is easy or difficult, but it is balanced in such a manner that we'll be able to deduce certain very important qualities which are, as per us and the pool of faculties, very important for you to be a part of our pilot batch. An anonymous attendee is asking me a question. Can I upload YouTube videos that is made by me in PDF?
You would need PDF proof for that. And it's something that you have to take a subscription for. Video files do play in PDF, but...
Okay. Yeah. I think the fact really is that one would rather the process has been in the files, quality, I mean, nature of file, this, that, etc., has been specified so that it makes it easier for the interview, I mean, the people who are participating in the process of evaluating the portfolio, find it easier to stay consistent with the, you know, opening and closing files, which are same, identical across the portfolios, because it otherwise wastes time. And one would rather spend time looking at the work rather than opening a link or, you know, working with different formats and so on and so forth. So I hope that should not pose as a problem, because I think the intention is so that one can spend more time looking at the work rather than, you know, having any technology delay that entire interaction.
Medha Nair is asking us, is there a focus on how we stylize, format all these things within the portfolio?
I don't understand the words, understand what you mean by stylized in this context, but no, we just need PDFs and moving image files. And I don't know where...
Probably the look and feel of it. That's what they mean. As in, how does this look? Will you be focused on that? That's what they're asking.
No, I think we're focused more on the work itself. So I don't think if you're looking at formatting and issues like that, it should be communicable and it should be clearly understood by the person who's going to evaluate it. So, I mean, you don't need to put bells and whistles on your layout at all. That's not required. But keep your work as the primary thing that the evaluator will see.
Okay, Nandita is again asking us one more question. Does the portfolio need to have different materials like woodworking, clay, etc.?
If you have engaged with all these materials, sure.
Okay.
It would be nice to see.
Okay.
Kavya Shivastava. It's not mandatory, but not mandatory.
Okay. Kavya Shivastava is asking us, may I add a link to the video work in the portfolio instead of uploading separately?
No, that would actually make it very inconvenient. So the decision has been to put it in the video and audio folder.
Good. So So I'm getting a lot of questions. I'll just sum it up about the interview. Many students are scared. So I'm not asking specific questions to you, but they are saying, is it going to be tough? What form of questions? Is it going to be purely, centered around the portfolio? Or are they going to be personality connected questions? We have covered all these, but I think still they want us to throw some more light on it.
Want to go, Jitendra? I can go after you.
No, you go ahead. I think you're the best person to answer this question and also relieve the anxiety.
Yeah. No, I think there isn't anything to worry about. Just treat it as a group of people who you do not know and are meeting for the first time. But you want to tell them who you are in the best manner in which you can, right? Your qualifying test has done its job. Your portfolio submission has done its job, because hopefully you have been paying attention to both these steps. And now the interview process is really about understanding you a little more as a person. Okay, so there may be personality questions. There may be questions related to the work you've submitted. So I don't think it'll be outside of the canvas of who you are. It'll just be directed to who you are. So if you say, oh, I love reading detective novels, they're going to ask you, who's the author that you like? And which book did you read? What did you like about it? So if you say you haven't read, they can't ask you a question. You say, okay, so you don't read. So then there's no question there for you, right?
True.
So don't worry. It's only around who you are, and they're just trying to understand you better. So they make an informed choice of whether you would enjoy doing design or not.
Jitin, do you want to add something to it?
No, I think this is the answer that even I want to hear at times when I'm feeling nervous about things. I need a counselor like that, a guide, a mentor like that in my life too. So that's why I said Binita is the best person for a lot of these questions, because not only are they precise, but they're also very calming.
Adding to that, let me tell you, this entire admission office of ours is based on a philosophy, and that philosophy is very clear that whatever course we are selecting you, these interviews are basically a kind of an interaction between faculty and the student to understand, so there is this word in Hindi called as Gurutvakarshan, right? Gurutvakarshan, it translates into gravity. The word guru is there, right? And akarshan is there. It means your attraction to the teacher, the gravity towards the teacher. So this is basically not an interview. So all of you, calm down, It's not going to be an interview per se where there is going to be a KBC kind of a round, options will be given to you, phone a friend will be given, nothing. It's just an interaction where a faculty would sit with you for some minutes and try to understand you, because they'll be the people who will be responsible to create a student out of you by the end of the fourth year, who goes on and, creates, that magic which I just said, brand fits design, right? So we are very clear that we meet our students once and we see to it that how they are, what they are. So personality-based questions are also not going to be where we are trying to judge you, or we are trying to put something, in brackets and say, okay, arrogant, brash. No. That's not what we are looking at. Our idea is very simple. Are you someone who is connected to the course as per a faculty? Now, I'll tell you, these interactions are a part of all other schools also. Like in School of Law, we do look at a student's diction, a student's comprehension, a student's clarity of thought. There's a reason behind it, because all those things are important, right? For doing law. Here, the parameters are totally different, and the faculties know better what are those parameters. So you'll only be judged on that. How you appear, etc., etc. Because designers, they have a totally different persona, right? So that's not probably something on our mind. We are more looking for the talent which is required to do these kind of courses. And I'm 100% sure the way our philosophy works, you will have a great experience, because our experience with all other schools are, post this interaction, there have been parents and students who have written to us appreciating the fact that this round has been conducted, because You know, at times there are so emotional emails and phone calls which come to us, which say, we haven't seen our child speak so much with enthusiasm. Now we understand that why do they want to do this course? So that's the punch of it, right? So don't take it as an interview and be scared. Calm down. You have done a very good, you are selected for interaction itself means that you have done a good deal of job. So the other thing is to just sit with the faculty and, you know, make them feel that you deserve a seat in the prestigious BITS Design School. Okay. Now, there is a question by anonymous attendee. I don't know why you guys are sending such beautiful questions as an anonymous attendee. I cannot even take your name here. There's a student who has asked me a question that do poems, all poems not connected to design but connected to life count, as if they can be of dark genres or anything else?
Absolutely.
I read that question and admired it. Please go ahead, Vinita. Yeah.
Yes, absolutely. It has every space in design. It definitely can be submitted as part of who you are. It'd be a joy to read.
Great.
Darkness is your main character, let it be.
Huh?
We talked about main character energy, right? So if dark
yes.
defines your main character energy, then let it
yeah.
be.
Yeah.
Okay, there's a question by Ishan. He's asking which kind of portfolio is more preferred, digital or physical?
You have to make it digital now. I mean, even if it's hand drawings, you've got to take pictures of it and compile them in a digital file and submit. So there's no preference. There's no preference really. There was a related question to this. I think somebody had asked. It was on my mind right now, but I just slipped it. Yeah, this whole balance of what should I really include, digital or handwork. Don't worry. We want to see how you express yourself through your skills, right? And there's a variety of skills that we've given to you. So the variety could include from, say, oh, I write poems, to I sing, to I dance, to I also draw, to I also paint, to I just splash color on the walls. My parents get angry, but well, I'm proud of it because it allows me to express in a certain way and I've taken pictures of it. And I like to share. I like to share the thought behind it. Sure, go ahead. Go ahead.
Great. Nandita has also asked us one question, which I'll answer. By when does the passing certificate need to be provided? Whenever you get the passing certificate, you have to provide us with the same. And that is usually before the starting of our session. So I'll tell you, all of you, you know, all the people who are attending, the offer letter and the admission letter which you will get will be provisional. Okay. It's that's the process which every university does. It's provisional because on the day of orientation, when you come to join, you need to bring all your originals, right? We are not going to keep it. There is a Supreme Court ruling that no institution in this country can keep your originals. Why do we require the originals? We will take the photocopy, we'll vet it, we'll check, or we'll compare it with the original. We'll return you back the original. Once this process is done, only then your admission gets confirmed anywhere, you know, anywhere. So that is the process when your admission gets convinced. By that time, you should have your passing certificate. And usually by that time, your passing certificate will be with you. Either it's at CBSE, ICSE, whatever board it is, you will get that. But if there is an exception that your passing certificate did not come on time, so we are ready to wait. You'll just have to write an undertaking that you will be providing us by a given date. You'll be allowed to attend the session also, the classes also, but then your admission shall remain provisional. It means it can be cancelled anytime. Okay. I hope that answers your question. Okay. So, a lot of questions here.
Deepu, sorry
yeah.
to interrupt. But is there a
yeah.
way that we could get a response from students to say whether they found our explanations and answers satisfactory? So maybe a thumbs up or some way of... We also as humans get nervous. And we also want to communicate clearly when we are asking them to communicate. And it really
yes.
We could
More,
just give
them many of them are sending thank you messages the moment we answer. My problem is I have to skim through the or my team, I think they're very busy because there are so many questions which are coming. So they are just answering them. So I have to do it myself. Otherwise, they usually send me the questions. Okay. I think we have covered most of the questions here. They are all repeat questions which are coming. Yeah, most of them are repeat questions. Okay, there is one question. I think you spoke about Instagram Reels. So a question is, shall we link Insta Reels in the PDF itself?
No. Don't link anything. Download.
No links.
No links.
Okay.
I don't want to be impressed by the number of followers you have. Not right now. Eventually, I will.
So there is another person who's asking, I have never actually made any computer generated work. So do I need to make that? Are they compulsory?
No. No.
We've answered that. We've answered that.
There's an academic question. Should I ask you that? Because there is a student, she's asking, Anushka Shukla, she's asking, sir, could you expand on what design concept means as a subject?
Vinita. Throwing all the difficult questions at you, I'm sorry.
No, I mean, design concepts as a course?
Yeah.
As a course?
There were two related questions. One is design concept, and one is design concept and aptitude that would be a part of DAT. So apparently DAT, there are components of DAT, and one of the components is design concept and aptitude. So this person wanted to know what each of these are and how can one test them? How does one go about testing them?
Okay, so I think there are a variety of, there's an aim in design and you have to get there. Now, there are various steps that one can follow depending upon what the aim of the solution is, right? And there are strategic steps that are taken in order to be able to arrive there. So what is the investigative quality in it? How do you analyze it? How do you critique it? How do you glean the knowledge out of it and move into the subsequent steps? Now, these are all processes that are part of unpacking anything, actually. And whether you take design thinking and concepts to management or this or that, you're basically trying to unravel something. So do you have that capacity and that propensity to do that kind of thinking, step by step, stage by stage, complexity to complexity, from simple to complex? Yeah. So, and how connected is your thinking? So are you being able to relate ideas together and scenarios together? So if I'm actually looking at a particular problem, and I don't look at the entire story, but I only look at that minuscule little problem that I'm confronted with, then the related might be causing a problem, and I'm not looking at the connected aspects, yeah? But I'm only looking at it in a very myopic, small way. So I lose the whole picture. So am I looking at all the connections that actually contribute to the making of that little problem, right? Now, in unpacking, I have to look at all the aspects which are connected with that problem, right? So if you say, for instance, take a mushroom, yeah, or you take a mycelium in the soil, yeah, what is the function of the mycelium in the soil? What does it do? If I don't look at how it affects the trees or how it solves problems for the trees or the birds or the this or the that, I'm looking at it in a very isolated way. And therefore, I can't understand the idea of a forest. Does that? So these are all concepts related to understanding things holistically. And do I have that capacity to understand things holistically is what this is about, design concepts is about.
Thank you so much, Vinita. This was wonderful.
Pujita is asking us a question. She's asking, is there a limit for how long ago these projects were done? I have a few from few years ago before lockdown, and I would like to know if I can include them.
Doesn't matter. Yeah, anytime, anytime. Even when they were 4 years old, if they did something, is fine. If they
Yeah,
had it.
If it is relevant to your story now, and if it
Yeah.
holds value, it holds value to us.
Yeah.
And another question is, what if there is so much work in various fields? Should we stick to one or show all of them?
I think one of the points, and that's a very good point, we forgot to mention that we would really like to see a variety of work. I think this was another question that people had asked. Should I include 10 to 15 images of only one project? Or can I include different projects? We
No,
would definitely
variety.
variety. We'd like to see that.
Variety. Yeah.
Someone as Insomnia is also asking the number of them, as in, you know, how many pages are we adding in our PDF file? Could you please answer this question? Like, how many paintings, pictures, creative
No.
elements should we be adding?
See, again, see, this is your story. If painting holds more importance to your, if you enjoy doing painting more than anything else, and therefore you've done a lot of it, then obviously it'll be a majority in your work, and rest of the work would be less. On the other hand, there's someone who's created models more and less paintings, then obviously the proportion of models would be more because they could show variety of models they have done, the variety of skills they've used, the variety of materials they've used to create those models. So I think it totally depends on the proportion that is with you, just distribute it proportionately in the portfolio. Or there could also be a person who could say, well, I've done very several different things, and I've tried about 15 different types of things in my entire life, and I like to show only one sample of it. Fair enough. Fair enough. Just one sample of all those 15 things that you've tried is also good. 10 samples of only painting work, but different kinds of paintings or different subjects or different experiments that you've done would really work. And rest 5 could be something else that you've done. And I'm giving these numbers on top of my head. I'm not saying it is essential to include 10 of these and 5 of these. It could be 7, 8, 6, 5, 9, 6, whatever it is. That is up to you. And that is also a part of your storytelling skill, right? That we want to see is how do you distribute or give importance or prioritize these things? Because story is not just about blabbering away content. It's also about how much importance do I give to which character or what kind of energy, right? Some characters are killed off very early in a film because they're not important to the story after that, right? So similarly, if a project is not important after a certain point, don't talk about it. It's okay. It's done its job. Now move on to the second project. I don't know if this made sense.
Yeah, and I think it's primarily about how you want us to see you as a person in terms of what all you engage with. If it's singular, it's fine. If it's multiple things, that's great. So how do you want us to perceive you? Or who are you really? So you have to tell us who you are through the work and the choices you make to submit the work. That's also a process of telling us who you are, of selection, right?
How much do you weigh a certain project in the storytelling, and how do you distribute that? How do you assemble it on the PDF? All of that is part of your story.
So in the interim, I would also want to tell all the people here that you have some questions which are specifically related to admissions. Like Madam Kavita Govind is asking us about how do we match, how do we give specific need, singular focus to such students. I would request you that if you go to our website, there is also an option of video counseling, where one of our able counselors, they will be on video with you to answer to these questions specifically. Because I admire the question that you have posted here, but I cannot ask that to the faculties here. It's specifically an admission related inquiry, for which what you could do is you can either email it to us or else book a video counseling with one of our counselors, and they'll make sure that you know, the problem that you are addressed can be addressed here. Nitesh Sri Raman has a question, which would be the last question of the day, because I think we have already overshoot the time which was given to us. It's almost going to be 2 o'clock. This would be the last question, because he feels that his previous question was not properly addressed. He's asking, can an example Can an example portfolio be shown to help us see how a story can be told through a portfolio? While the faculty did show things that can be included in a portfolio, I would like an example as to how these things can be strung together to form a story. How do we answer that?
But that's something that we have debated about when we were planning this webinar. We've debated, in fact, faculty have debated about it.
And our conclusion was that giving a sample would mean that we are restricting the creativity of the student in the manner that they'd start to follow that example. And then they'll say, look, you gave me that sample. I've done it. Now select me. Right? So what we want to do is instead of giving exact prescription, giving you guidelines, how you follow those guidelines, whether you choose to adhere or not adhere, or how much do you choose to adhere, is also a part of your creative process that we'd like to see. And believe me, we've had a debate about it. We've had a debate, but the consensus is, and I appreciate that consensus, is that please feel free to interpret. And please feel free to take whatever you understand of it and bring it to the table. Believe me, there are no rights and wrongs. So a lot of us are very worried about, oh, I didn't put that image that said it. That's why didn't it select me. Oh, I did not do this. But that was said in the webinar. And no, there are no rights and wrongs. We are flexible. But in the broad framework that we've created for you, we want you to play. Vinita, please add to this. I really want you to add to this.
I think that was a very conscious decision, because putting together a portfolio is making choices, because we've given you a limit of 25 MB. Yeah. So these are choices that you make, and you have to sit and think as to how I'm going to put this together. If we were to show you a sample, it is somebody else's thought process. They have spent time thinking about how to put their portfolio together, and we are giving it to you as an example. It doesn't work. It's like if I took a portfolio that you had designed and showed it as an example to somebody else, it does not work. You have to decide some things, and these are decisions that you have to take. And I know that you have always had somebody tell you how to do something. This is your first step in how do I want to do it? Yeah, and that's a choice. This is the first choice. There are umpteen number of choices you will have to make every day when you join design. Yeah, so let's start here and decide for ourselves as to how I want to be perceived by the group who is interviewing me. Yeah, is that fair?
Yes, Vinita. Wonderful.
But when we were having this debate, Vinita, I frankly put myself in the shoes of a 17 or 18 year old and say, if I was very confused, where would I go for answers? The faculty is not answering. The school is choosing not to answer because they want to test our choices as well. So where do I? So I just went to YouTube and said, hey, are there any tips for making a portfolio for design school? And believe me, I found umpteen number of links and people who are giving certain tips and tricks. Some of them will work for you, some of them will not. We don't, of course, prescribe them. But if you need any assistance of that sort, there are, in this world of internet, there are sources available on the World Wide Web. Feel free to take references. Referencing is something that is not, referencing is different from copying. Please use it as a reference. And if it allows you to take the next step and move forward, and allow to kind of remove that mental block that you're facing, please use it and move on. Difference from a video I'd seen. So I've organized it this way. Fair enough, no problem.
Yeah, but just make sure that you don't take references where the choice of what you want to put in goes out of your hand. Okay,
yeah.
Keep the control within yourself and you decide how you want to present your work that you've done so far in life.
I just hope, I hope that we've answered your question, because I know you felt dissatisfied with the question that we'd answered earlier. So if we've answered your question, please, please, please respond. Please say something.
You can just, send on the webinar chat, yes. So we'll wait for you before we end the session. And by that time, I would request Kumaran to just, yeah. So just in case there are some people who are not able to take the screenshot of these important dates, I would want you all to just go through these dates. Make sure you stick to the timelines. There were people who were asking me how many applications. Don't worry about all those things. There will be applications. Like I said, you know, every school under BITS Pilani, the moment it is launched, the interest is so high that we do not have dearth of application. So don't think about it. If you have applied, if you have fulfilled all the criteria, you will get selected. Okay? So don't be under that pressure, please. So these are the dates. Moving on to the next slide, Kumar. Yeah, this is another important date sheet. So please be mindful of the last marked criteria, you know, qualifying examination, portfolio, and interview. This is like very, very important for us. Someone also requested us to go through the portfolio slide. One, can we go to that slide also, because they had missed out the other one? The one with the table. Yeah. Before that. One slide up. Yeah. So I think this was one slide which three people had asked me to go and just see once more. I think there are questions about how do we compare with other design schools. See, every institution has its own way, philosophy of working. We have our own philosophy of working. There's no institution which is good or bad, in those terms. It's basically every student has a place where he or she is going to study, right? So if you think that you and our faculties match with each other, you should come and join this institution. If there is another institution which can do better justice, go to them. So there is no point of comparing like this. Specifically in the field of education, that is what I have felt. So it's basically professional fields like design, etc. It is always, always the faculties who would be with you throughout your life. So, that's how it is. Even after graduating, you will be in touch with your faculties. So your faculties matter a lot. Their guidance matters a lot. So that is something which you need to check for yourself. And it's not for us to tell you that how it is. That's what BITS, the lineage and the legacy which it carries right from the BITS Pilani, is something which we will maintain. And we have maintained in all other institutions, be it the Dubai campus, be it the Hyderabad campus, the campuses which we have opened, all of them have maintained the same. So that's exactly how we are doing it. Our international collaborations also, if you see with Aldo, RMIT, Stanford, that's exactly how we plan to maintain even the standard of education which we are into. Okay. And thank you for those sweet comments by Dakshita and many other people, Vanalini, etc., who have sent us great, some very sweet comments that this was a great session. They have spoke highly about both our panelists. So, I extend their greetings to all to both the panelists also, that they have learned a lot through this. We will also make sure that the recording of this session reaches you in form of a mail. There will be a gratitude mail which we send to all our attendees. So we'll 100% send it to you. So you'll get a recording of this session also with you in your inbox soon. Okay, we'll have to edit it. So allow us, and then Holi is also there. So allow us a few days where, we don't want to bog our studio people behind the scenes, but it will hit your inbox soon. Okay. And thank you so much again to all of you for investing your Sunday with us and being a part of this discussion, where I'm 100% sure it was fruitful to each one of you. Gratitude from BITS Design. Thank you to both our esteemed panelists, who again were so, so, so clear about each and everything, that I'm 100% sure those students who are aspirants have a good idea about what we intend to, how we intend to, and the most important part of portfolio is now clear to them. right? If there is any doubt which remains, my dear attendees, you please reach out to us through emails. I've also told you about the video counseling which we do. There are also phone numbers on which you can connect to us. All of those instructions are given on our website. Even about our courses also, illustratively, each and everything is explained on our website. Please do go to the website, get in touch with us, and make an informed decision. Okay. Happy Holi, each one of you. May the Holi be as bright as the colors, and humanity is able to triumph every good over evil. Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Deepan. Thank you, everyone. Bye. Bye, Benita. Talk to you soon.
Bye. Yeah.